Welcome, my name is Andreas Dreger and you are watching the Systems Biology channel. In this video, we will first explore how to embed a manually drawn map within an SBML file. We will then discuss how to prepare a published timecost dataset for visual analysis with SBML Simulator. The Big Models database provides genome-scale metabolic models for various organisms. Let's search for a model of yeast or Saccharomyces cerevisiae among them. From these two, we pick IMM904 that Monica Moe and colleagues created in 2009 for a publication in BMC Systems Biology. We can download the model in compressed SBML format. At the bottom of the page, we can find a map of the central carbon metabolism. Let's download that map in JSON format. We can convert the map to SBML with layout information using the software Azure Converter that is available at github.com/drager-lab. To this end, we download the executable JAR file of Azure Converter and run it from the command line to generate an SBML layout file. The SBML file we obtained from Azure Converter, however, only contains those parts of the model with relevance for the graphical display. The reason is that the original Azure map also does not provide the full model, so we need to merge the core model we downloaded from Big with this SBML layout model. To this end, we need to update all references from the layout components to the so-called SBML core components. For small models, we could do this manually, but for a model of this size, it can be conducive to write a little script that does it for us. The result is an SBML file of the full model with links to layout information. So, we briefly discussed how to convert different model file formats. A few of these steps might still seem a bit complicated and require some degree of code writing, but we can expect that more models with embedded layouts will become available, as also their software support is steadily improving. In 2012, Basti Bergdahl and colleagues published Timecourse Metabolite Profiling in Yeast as part of their work in Biotechnology for Biofuels. Let's see what happens when we load this laboratory dataset onto our network. First, we need to adjust the data a bit so that SBML Simulator can read them. The original dataset is an Excel spreadsheet that contains several tabs. Let's go to the tab of raw intracellular concentrations. There are even repeated time points with measurements taken for several compounds, some of which are so-called NaN values or none values, indicating a missing value. For our purposes, we need precisely one value per time point. To this end, we create a new table below where we calculate the median value of every measurement. Thereby, we skip all NaN values. As the table head, we use the compound identifier from above, but prefixed with M underscore. In this way, the IDs fit those in the SBML model and make it easier to map the data to our network graph. There's one compound in the dataset for which the model does not have any counterpart, so we can skip it in our new table, but SBML Simulator would also automatically ignore a column without a corresponding model component. Since SBML assumes initial time points to be zero, we also shift all time values in our dataset by roughly 14 time units. We now save this new table in a CSV file, which is a file of character-separated values. Summarizing, we also discussed how to transform experimental data using Excel. In the next video, we'll import both generated files to SPML Simulator and fully explore its visualization capabilities. Thanks for watching the Systems Biology channel.